With the Innovation Nation series we've been doing, kind of reading through all the stories, one of the themes that I feel like is kind of emerging as we tackle a whole bunch of different topics is kind of that Canada has a real opportunity to seize the future economy, but we may be missing that opportunity if we're not really proactive, and in some cases we're not being as proactive as we need to, we could be falling behind. What do you make of that? Do you think as a country we're innovative enough?
Well, I beg to differ a bit. I think we have turned the corner. I think we are starting to create this culture of innovation in Canada where we have an economy that works for everyone. And we as a government have done a very, you know, proactive set of measures to really address those issues around investing in people and skills and lifelong learning, really focusing on making sure that companies have the capital that they need and really allowing businesses to grow and scale. And so we ran on that in 2015. We were very clear that we're going to make investments in Canadians. We're going to focus on helping to see more growth in the economy. We've seen that. The economy is now growing at 3%. The fastest growth rate in the G7, and the unemployment rate is at a historic low at 5.6%. So 800,000 jobs have been created. And it's really a function of the investments we made in infrastructure, tax policy, trade policy, but also innovation. And the key part is that it's benefiting the many, not just the few. And it's creating good quality jobs. And we're really focused on making sure that it's also inclusive, that it benefits people living in rural Canada, that it benefits young people that are getting coding. So that's really our goal, and we're seeing that culture emerge in Canada of innovation in creating a nation of innovators.
Why is the government's responsibility so broad in this? It's striking reading this Nation of Innovators report. You know, there's money for fundamental research, for incubators, for scale-ups, yeah. For like every stage along the way. Why does, is Canada just not innovative enough? Like why does the government need to be dragging the economy into innovation? Can't we just get out of the way and let this happen?
We're in a race. We're competing with other jurisdictions. We want to level the playing field. Do you think China is getting out of the way? You think Europe is getting out of the way? You think the United States is getting out of the way? No, they're all playing an active role. They're all engaged with sectors and industry and businesses to make sure that they have an advantage. But obviously in Canada, we're very fortunate. Not only are we blessed with an incredible country in landmass and natural resources, but our number one value proposition is our people. It's what differentiates Canada. But at the same time, we can't just rely on that. We really have to play an active role. I go to every jurisdiction. If you go to the UK, they have a Catalyst Initiative where they create these incubators to bring in academia and businesses to work together to help companies scale and grow. If I go to Israel, we talk about that country and all the innovation work that they do. Government plays an active role. Same thing with Germany, South Korea. So my point being is everyone else is doing it. Why would we take a hands-off approach? The Conservatives clearly presented that as an option in 2015, that the laissez-faire approach, they have their heads in the sand, and they're like, we're gonna let this thing unfold accordingly. But we recognize that puts our companies, and more importantly, Canadians at a disadvantage. So it's about partnership, it's about collaboration, it's about creating an ecosystem, but it's creating the conditions of success for Canadians to get more job opportunities, and more importantly, for our companies to grow and stay here in Canada.
If we get this wrong, what is the potential pitfall? What are you worried that will happen if we don't compete sufficiently against Israel, against Germany, against the US?
Well, we miss out on opportunities. Why did my father come here in 1972? For better economic opportunities for my brother and I. And so the hopes that I have for future generations, including my daughters, is that they have the ability to succeed. So it's really a big deal. These are about a quality of life. It's about jobs. It's about our children and grandchildren. And so we recognize that we have to play an active role. We can't remain on the sidelines. We can't be idle about this stuff. And it's a big deal because if we take away that hope, remember, this is the first generation that's not as optimistic about their kids as previous generations. And that is problematic. And that's why, for us, our legacy as a government, when it comes to the innovation plan, when it comes to creating this culture of innovation, is to make sure that we have a country and an economy that works for everyone, and basically making sure that we have a country full of innovators. And that'll just create those opportunities. And it's really about jobs, it's about growth, and a quality of life.